Philharmonia Fantastique is a 25-minute journey inside the orchestra, a kind of concerto for orchestra where you get to go right up next to the instruments and inside them sometimes to see how they work. I decided that we should have each of the four families of the orchestra inhabit their own completely different kind of sound worlds, almost different kind of genres, to make them like four distinct tribes. And the reason we wanted to do that is to create a kind of dramatic tension between the four different tribes of the orchestra that has to be resolved by them coming together. And the way they ultimately come together is to learn to play each other's themes, to kind of speak each other's tongues. And that element of coming together, transcending the differences that they have, became a key inspiration for us as the piece unfolded. Piece began with a conversation between me and Gary Rydstrom of Lucasfilm and Skywalker Sound. Gary is a multi-Oscar winning sound designer for Steven Spielberg and also a director of animated films. I was amazed at those films' ability to blend music and animation in such a seamless way.
I love the idea of using film and animation in particular to visualize music, and Mason's music would be really fun to visualize. The unique part about this project is that the music and the film were created in parallel together. The first person I thought of trying to visualize how this could work was Jim Capobianco, who I worked with at Pixar and have known his work, including work that's very charming and emotional and expresses itself in a very pure way. I met with Jim, and it took about 3, maybe 4 seconds to talk him into doing this project.
Gary Rydstrom reached out to me. He mentioned he had this project he was developing with a composer named Mason Bates. And he said, we want to combine animation with a new symphony piece. We kind of came up with a style that's kind of hand-drawn 2D animation, but also mixed with live action. It was a really good push and pull because Gary and I would come up with some kind of concept to visualize the music and then start to develop it and show Mason. Mason would say we're missing certain elements that he would want to put in. We'd add those in and we'd always plus it and make it better.
We don't always think about the orchestra as a marvel of technology, but it very much is one of the best examples of interactive technology we have. Philharmonia Fantastique all comes together in the concert hall in a live performance for orchestra and animated film that takes the audience inside the instruments to see how they work.